everybody, welcome back to SV Handmaids. So in our today's episode, we are going to see how to do this edge quilling. So these are the strips that I cut from my cutting machine. You would require a gift card, a tweezer, and a good tacky glue. You can even use a fabric glue. But runny glue will not work. You need a real thick quality of glue. So let me put all this aside. So I already have prepared my base and done half of the quilling in it. So I'm trying to mix traditional as well as contemporary quilling in this. So the dark blue ones that you see are the traditional quilling. It's called the beehive technique. You have this recording already on my channel, so you can check out that video. I'll put it in the description box. So today we are going to see those yellow colored filling inside these alphabets. These are called edge quilling, and edge quilling I have also done on the outside as a border. So we are also going to do filling inside of these alphabets. So for this, we need very precise measuring of the strips. So these strips are all of equal size. The height of it is all same. So we measure and cut the strip and then hold it with your tweezer and then see the placement inside. See if the length of the strip will fit in. Then you can dip it in the glue and then place it inside in the slot where you planned. So it will look like this. So the way you place your strips, the distance between each of them should be equal so that it looks neat and gives a good finish. So every strip needs to be measured and then cut, then dipped in glue. Use as little glue as possible, because too much glue will not make the strip stand straight. It will immediately try to fall over. So the little glue you use will help it to stay stiff and get, and the glue will dry up faster. So take as little as possible. If anything is excess, you can just tap on the card itself and then you place it inside your alphabet or shape or wherever you want to fill it. So this is the latest style. This is a contemporary style in quilling. The traditional filling is the regular shapes which you do with your quilling tool. So this does not require any tool at all. You just have to snip the quilling strip and then place it in with the help of a tweezer. The regular quilling strip cannot be used for this kind of edge quilling. You need to use cardstock. So these are thicker sheets, little bit more thicker than the regular chart paper that you get in the market. So these are little more thick and they are called cardstock. So the cardstock, you get cardstock strips in the market, but I cut my own strips. So I'm trying to fill it in. So as you keep filling it in, you can just go back and forth and adjust your strips. Make sure they are all lined up and equal distances. So before it's completely dry, if you are not satisfied with the position, you can always pull out the strip using a tweezer and then place it back properly. Having a small scissors and a tweezer is very, very handy and helps working with this kind of project. Bigger scissors won't work, so you have to use a very tiny scissor which has got sharp pointy blades. which can reach in between the strips to just cut them. So I have used a green cardstock also for the other colored filling. So but that I have used a crimper tool to crimp and then add it to the shape. So you can use your tweezer to run it along the strip to make it straight if it's trying to bend over. It takes really a lot of patience and you cannot hurry. So once you are done with 3-4 strips, take it up, view it from a different angle, make sure everything looks right and they are straight without falling over before proceeding forward. So once you complete everything, then you cannot make any adjustments. So after every 3-4 strips, just have a look at how you have glued it in. See if everything looks okay to you. If any of the strips don't look straight or doesn't seem to fit in properly, you can always remove it immediately before it completely dries. So now we have filled in most of the stuff, but you see on the corners there is still some space where I feel I can insert one strip at the ends. So don't leave any gaps completely. It should be filled to give a good neat finish. Don't take too much glue at a time on the card. Having just one squirt of glue, then finish it up and then you can add some more because the glue is going to dry up soon because it's really thick. The normal runny glue, paper glue, will not work because this needs to dry faster so that the cardstock doesn't fall on its sides. So use a thicker glue and use little bit quantity at a time, and then as you work you can keep adding glue to your card. Don't use paper or post-it notes or cardstock or anything for placing your glue because as the glue is drying, your strip is going to get stuck there. So these kind of credit cards or plastic cards will work better because you can peel off the glue later on. Once it dries, you can even peel the glue away and then reuse the cards. And as you're doing your project, your strip also will not get stuck to the glue. So hope you got an idea of how the edge quilling is done. So this is part of a bigger project. So my next video will be putting together everything, arranging them into a quilt frame. Thank you so much. Stay tuned, subscribe, and do share with people who might be interested. Thank you.